यन्मायावशवर्ति विश्वमखिलं ब्रह्मादिदेवासुरा यत्सत्वादमृषैव भाति सकलं रज्जौ यथा हेर्भ्रमः यत्पादप्लवमेकमेव हि भवां बोधे स्थितीर्षावतां वन्देऽहं तमशेषकारणपरं रामाख्यमीशं हरिम्। हरिओम। इन द लास्ट टू दोहास वी सॉ डिफरेंट आइडियाज अबाउट नाम महिमा, दैट इज द प्रकरण आई एम गोइंग ऑन। एंड इन द लास्ट दोहा नंबर 22, गोस्वामी जी पॉइंटेड आउट दैट देर आर फोर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डिवोटीज हु बेनिफिट बाय टेकिंग भगवान्स नेम। वन इज ज्ञानी भक्त। फॉर ज्ञानी भक्त वाइल इन व्यवहार दे डोंट गेट अफेक्टेड बाय व्यवहार बाय ऑलवेज चैंटिंग भगवान्स नेम। देन इज जिज्ञासु, वन हु इज ईगर टू नो समथिंग मोर अबाउट लाइफ, वॉन्टिंग टू स्टडी वेदांत, साधक जिज्ञासु ऑल्सो बेनिफिट्स बाय टेकिंग भगवान्स नेम। अर्थार्थी भक्त वॉन्ट समथिंग फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड, बट गुड थिंग इज ही गोस एंड आस्क्स भगवान, सो ही ऑल्सो गेट्स वॉट ही वॉन्ट्स। एंड आर्थ भक्त इज द वन हु इज इन नीड ऑफ हेल्प एंड सीकिंग हेल्प फ्रॉम भगवान, सो ही गेट्स वॉट एवर ही वॉन्ट्स। द मेन थिंग ऑफ दिस दोहा इज वी शुड फॉल इन एटलीस्ट वन ऑफ दोज कैटेगरीज, बिकॉज देर इज अनदर कैटेगरी विच इन भगवद गीता द डिस्टिंक्शन इज डन एज दुष्कृतिनः एंड सुकृतिनः। सो ऑल दीज फोर आर सुकृतिनः, मीन्स इवन इफ दे हैव डिजायर, दे वॉन्ट नॉलेज, दे वॉन्ट टू कम आउट ऑफ सम सिचुएशन, दे आर टेकिंग भगवान्स नेम। एंड अनदर कैटेगरी इज कॉल्ड एज दुष्कृतिनः, दे डोंट इवन इंक्लूड भगवान इन देयर लाइफ। सो अवर रोल एज अ साधक शुड बी टू फॉल इन दैट सुकृतिनः कैटेगरी, one of those four, if not one the second, not the second third, if not third then the fourth one. And it will also happen at different phases in our life, we might fall under one category or the another. It's not cut and dry four different groups. Sometimes when difficulties come in life we might be artha bhakta. Sometimes when we are seeking certain siddhis for our sadhana, like for example memory, you know, you go to any ashram in Sandipani, what is expected is we should memorize all the text, so that is one kind of siddhi we are seeking. So then we become artharthi bhakta, we are seeking Bhagwan give me good memory so that I can remember Ramcharitmanas, I can remember Bhagavad Gita and dwell upon the meaning when I want. If it is there in memory, then it is like you are walking along with the text. Anytime you can bring any shloka and then cross-reference. So that is one type of siddhi that we are asking. So the same seeker can be artharthi at some point. And then the seeker goes and sits in a Vedanta class and is trying to understand, you know, what is this? What are they talking about? Drashta, drushya, this and that and so many other, you know, discussion is going on. Then the prayer is, Bhagwan, may I get clear knowledge about this and may I benefit from it. So in whichever way, whatever we want, Goswamiji says, Nama Japa will give us that. And the beauty of our Vedanta Shastra is, all sadhanas, they will tell how to do the sadhana, they will tell the result of that sadhana, and they will glorify the greatness of that sadhana. There won't be too much insistence that you should do it in this way only. Because sadhana is something which is very different to each and every person. So our shastra's role is to tell us the greatness of that sadhana. And once we have understood the value of it, it is up to the sadhaka now to put forth effort and own up and do that sadhana to see that result and to benefit from it. This kind of change that comes, a blossoming that happens in a seeker, stays for a longer time. If that seeker is told to do certain sadhana like nama japa or anything out of force, that person might end up doing it, but sooner or later it will become like a mechanical sadhana. So in our tradition, it is left to the student, after telling all the details, the meaning and the greatness of that sadhana, how to do it. If there are questions, again, we should come back to this portion and see what Goswamiji is talking about, or ask and discuss any sadhanas if there are questions. But after that, it is up to the seeker to do that sadhana. So now 23rd Doha we will chant, where Goswamiji is now arguing. Arguing means he is putting forth a logical standpoint to say how Nama Japa is greater than Nirguna Brahma and Saguna Brahma. Okay, so 23rd Doha we will see. Today I will try to turn on the tabla. Hopefully I will stay on talam. If I don't, then that is another chanting. Huh? We'll just go along. Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Rama 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 Aguna Saguna Dui Brahma Sarupa Akat Agadh Anadi Anupa मोरे मत बड़ नाम दुहुते किए जहि जुग निज बस निज भूते प्रौढ़ सुजन जनि जानहि जन की कहु प्रतीति प्रीति रुचि मन की एक दारुगत देखिए एकु पावक समजुग ब्रह्म विवेकु उभय अगम जुग सुगम नाम ते कहेहु नाम बड़ ब्रह्म राम ते व्यापकु एक ब्रह्म विनासी सत चेतन घन आनंद राशि अस प्रभु हृदय अछत अभिकारी सकल जीव जग दीन दुखारी नाम निरूपण नाम जतन ते सुप्रगटत जिमि मूल रतन ते निर्गुण ते ही भाति बड़ नाम प्रभाउ अपार कहु नाम बड़ राम ते निज विचार अनुसार सियावर रामचंद्र की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय उमापति महादेव की जय बोलो भाई सब संतन की जय श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय अगुण सगुण दुई ब्रह्म स्वरूपा ब्रह्मन इज ऑफ इज नोन इन टू वेस अगुण मीन्स निर्गुण एंड सगुण अगुण डस नॉट मीन वॉट डस नॉट हैव एनी क्वालिटीज और स्वामीजी यूज्ड टू से देयर वाज वन ब्रह्मचारी हु वाज नेम्ड अगुण चैतन्य So all other brahmacharis used to make fun of him and say, your teacher did not find any guna in you. That is why he named you as Aguna Chaitanya. But Aguna means Nirguna. That which is beyond all names and forms, that is Aguna. Aguna Saguna Dui, Aguna Saguna Dui Brahma Sarupa. Akata Agada Anadi Anupa. Both are incomprehensible. they cannot be described, and they are infinite. More mata bada naam duhute. In Goswamiji's opinion, if you ask him, what is your opinion about whether Saguna is greater or Nirguna is greater? He says, name of Bhagwan is greater than both Nirguna Brahma and also Saguna Brahma. Kye jehi juga nija basa nija bhute. This name has made both Saguna and Nirguna come under its control. How? That he is going to explain. So this particular doha, number 23, is explaining how name is greater than Nirguna Brahma. Then he says that don't consider that this is only elaboration or some kind of praise that I am doing. Praudi sujana jani janahi janaki. Don't take these words as, you know, some casual remarks that, okay, name of Bhagwan is greater than Saguna and Nirguna. Kahahu pratiti priti ruchi manaki. I am telling after lot of deep thinking about this topic, and this is my conviction, what I've heard from my teachers and what I have seen for myself also, Goswamiji is saying. Now comes a very beautiful example. He says, what is the difference between Nirguna and Saguna? Eka darugata dekhiya eku. He says, Nirguna Brahma is like that unmanifest fire which is there in a firewood. So when you see a log of wood, fire is already there in it, but it is not manifest. So that unmanifest form of fire in that wood, he says, that is like Nirguna Brahma. Pavaka sama juga Brahma bibeku. And what is Saguna Brahma? That same unmanifest fire, when it becomes manifest, that is Saguna Brahma. Now here there is an interesting point that Goswamiji has brought. Elaboration of it you will find in Bhagavad Gita. In Bhagavad Gita, Bhagwan says, Samoham sarvabhuteshu name dveshosti napriyaha. I am the same to all beings. I don't have preference towards anybody. Neither am I more dear to somebody, nor am I hating someone. You know, I don't take anybody, I don't do any kind of partiality. Okay, that is why I am sama. And the line after that, Bhagwan says, Ye bhajanti tu mam bhaktya mai te teshu chapyaham. But those who worship me with devotion, I am theirs and they are mine. And there in that shloka, Bhagwan Shankaracharyaji gives the example of fire. What he says is that fire which is there, that will give warmth if we go closer to it. If we stay far from it and then complain, you know, this fire is not, it is only giving warmth to those who are, you know, some people, and it is not giving warmth to me. So then that complaint is not valid, because nobody has stopped us from going towards that fire. So the analogy is, Saguna Brahma is like that fire. Those who have devotion towards Bhagwan, they can derive that strength from Bhagwan. But those who choose to be far away, they cannot complain that, you know, we don't have this grace of Bhagwan, or we are not deriving this strength from Bhagwan. It is said we should start anywhere, wherever we are, and keep moving closer to that fire. And Nirguna Brahma is like that unmanifest fire. So in a firewood, no matter you are close or far, it doesn't make any difference. So Nirguna Brahma is sama in everybody's heart. But Saguna Brahma when that same Nirguna Brahma takes Upadhi to become Saguna Brahma, that Bhagwan we can derive strength from. This analogy, we should think about it more. Eka daru gata dekhiye eku, pavaka samajuga brahma viveku. One is like unmanifest fire, which is same in all firewood, any wood that we see. But we cannot remove our cold from that. Means what? For us in our vyavaharik world, we need a heart that is cheerful and joyful. And that cheerfulness, that ananda in antakarana, will come with this devotion to Bhagwan. That is the warmth, you know, that we have to derive in our everyday life. Ubhaya agama juga sugama namate, kahehu namu bada brahma ramate. He say, even though both are very difficult, even Saguna Brahma, for us to develop that love, that taste, that is also difficult. Nirguna Brahma, what to talk? It's so subtle to understand, that also becomes difficult. But Nama is greater than both because it prepares our mind. So that is the power of Nama Japa. Now Goswamiji gives a very Vedantic insight into, you know, some topics. You look at the next line. Vyapaku eka brahma abhinashi satachetana ghana ananda rasi. What is the nature of brahma? There is something called as brahma. But what is its nature? Its nature is vyapaka. It is all pervading. It is non-dual. Eka. Ekameva advitiyam, it is one without the second. Means there is no otherness in Brahma. And it is avinashi. It doesn't have any kind of destruction that can happen. Satachetana ghana ananda rasi. It is always present. It is of the nature of existence. What we chant in our Mangalacharanam shloka. Yat sattvat amrushaiva bhati sakalam. That because of which this entire creation gets existence, this ahankara gets existence. That is this Brahma. It is Chaitanya Swarupa. It is consciousness and ananda rashi. It is of the nature of bliss. Where is this Brahma? You know that you said there is some Brahma and that is having all these qualities, it is Ananda Swarupa. Next line he says, Asa Prabhu Hrudaya Achata Abhikari. This is Mahavakya. That Brahma which is all pervading is seated right in my heart. Asa Prabhu Hrudaya. Hrudaya means right in our heart, means it is an illuminator of thoughts. That Sakshi. That is this Brahma. Asa Prabhu Hrudaya Achata Abhikari. Oh, so Brahma is Ananda Swarupa, is seated right in my heart. Then I should also be Ananda Swarupa. You say, yes, that is true. That is how it should be. Then you see the next line. Sakala Jeeva Jaga Deena Dukhari. In spite of this great fact, that Brahma, which is all pervading, is our own true nature, we are still not able to benefit from it. Sakala Jeeva Jaga Deena Dukhari. This line, all saints have elaborated. Kabirji, when he says, Pani me meena piyasi, mohe suna suna avata hasi. Means this fish is thirsty in ocean. And, you know, listening to this, it looks very humorous, hilarious, you know, because how can this fish die of thirst when it is living in this ocean, in this, you know, water surrounding it everywhere? You see, that is our condition. We are living in the midst of ananda, but yet we are not able to benefit from it. Midst of ananda means our own nature is ananda swarupa, but we are not able to benefit from it. That is why Goswamiji says Nama is greater than Nirguna Rupa of Brahma. So this Chaupayi, that is that conclusion, Nama Nirupana Nama Jatanate. So having understood the glory of name of Bhagavan, Nirupana means that, you know, having understood the meaning of the name of Bhagavan, we should keep chanting it with effort. Jatana means what? Initially, it will not be easy. So first we should hear about it and then have Mahatva Buddhi in it. Mahatva Buddhi means Shraddha. That, you know, this is what I want to do. It is true with anything. Huh? Whatever we want to start new in life, the first step is to have Mahatva Buddhi in that thing. We should start feeling that this is important and this will benefit me. Nama Nirupana Nama Jatanate So Pragatata Jimi Mola Ratanate. When this happens, when Nama Japa is sufficiently done, then whatever obstacles were there, in Vedanta the word is Pratibandha. Those Pratibandhas will go away. And the same knowledge which was there before, that will shine forth more clearly in our mind. Means we'll be able to go through life on the strength of this knowledge. That I am complete by myself. I don't have to gain anything to become complete. I don't have to seek happiness outside because I myself am Ananda Swarupa. This conviction will get deeper and deeper as and when mind becomes purified. Nirgunate ihi bhati bada nama prabhavu apara kahahu nama bada ramate nija bichara anusara. So now you see, I have proven, Goswamiji is saying, huh? Compared to Nirguna Brahma, Nama Japa is greater because it's already a matter of fact that our nature is Ananda Swarupa, but yet we are Dukhi. There is nothing wrong in being Dukhi. We should just accept whatever, wherever we are right now. Okay, sadhana khandanam doesn't take us too far. So best is we should recognize where we are and then take support of whatever sadhanas are being pointed. So now Goswamiji is proving how Nama Japa is greater than Saguna form of Bhagavan. Before we chant that Doha, some introduction about what is Goswamiji going to do here now. In our Puranas, there are a lot of stories that come. Those of you who are teaching Balvihar or might have heard somewhere, you'll be very familiar with several stories that come in our Puranas and Itihasa also. Mahabharata Ramayana is considered as Itihasa because they were historic events that happened. And Puranas are portrayal of Upanishadic teachings, the philosophy, in a very poetic way. And in those stories, or in those Puranas, in those Itihasas, lot of stories are woven in, so that our mind stays there and it's easy for us to understand the philosophy. So there are three levels at which every incident should be looked at. First level is called as Adi Daivika level. Means in the Purana, whatever story has come, or in Itihasa, whatever story is given, that is called as Adi Daivika level. Then next level to look at that story is Adi Bhautika level. Means the same thing we will see in the world around today. That story which happened so many years ago, which is given in some Purana, the implications of that story or the message of that story will be relevant even in the world outside. That is Adi Bhautika. Third one is Adhyatmika. Means that story, whatever it is trying to communicate, that I can see in myself also. Means inside me, there is that same thing happening what was communicated in that story. आदिदैविक, आदिभौतिक एंड आध्यात्मिक. I'll give an example with which it will be clearer. All of you must have heard the story of Samudra Manthanam, right? Devas came, Asuras came, and then the Vasuki serpent was there, Meru mountain was there, and Kshirasagara. So that they started churning. This is Adidaivika story. In some Purana we have read, okay, that is Adidaivika. Adibhautika is the war or the, you know, the conflict that keeps happening between the good and the evil in the society outside. Always there is this tug of war. So what was communicated as Adidaivika, that gets emphasized as Adibhautika. Means how the society functions, that we can see through those stories. Okay, in the world outside. Now third comes Adhyatmika. Adhyatmika means in myself also, I can see these two qualities always at tug of war. The Shubha Vasanas and Ashubha Vasanas, the Devas and Asuras. So constantly there is a battle going on inside. Sometimes this person wins, sometimes that person wins. And whichever story we take, we should understand it at all these three levels. Sometimes what happens is, in the name of emphasizing more on adhyatmic, you know, points of that story, we completely miss Adidaivik. It looks as though it is some kind of fairy tale they are telling. Especially in Itihasa we see, some people say, you know, Mahabharata and Ramayana, oh, they are their stories. I say, no, they are Itihasa. It is Adidaivika Srishti. There it is possible. Very much it is there. So Adidaivika level, Adibhautika level, and Adhyatmika level. All three should be understood. The glory or greatness of studying stories at Adidaivika level, the first one, is that there is some sweetness in that philosophy, in that history. That is communicated in those stories. Recently, we were discussing all our history texts which are there, right? If you just look at it or read the recent history that we read in textbooks, they don't seem to be that appealing. Appealing in the sense, they don't have that rasa in them. Whereas itihasas like Mahabharata and Ramayana, they are also history, but they are written in such a way that new rasa can keep coming and that history becomes joyful. We can learn many things from that history. So this is the greatness of studying at Adidaivika level. Adibhautika level, when we see in the society those things happening, so then we realize the points that are mentioned in those texts are relevant even today. Right? It is not only limited to that story. Its relevance is there even today. And the purpose of that story is complete only when we understand Adhyatmika level. How am I supposed to benefit from that story? Okay, so this is the big picture idea of how to look at each story. The reason why I brought in this point at this stage is Goswamiji is going to say Bhagwan's avatara took place and he did lot of leelas. And those people whose Uddhara Bhagwan did in that particular avatara belongs to Adidaivika level. But what we want is how can we benefit from that leela? So there he says, with Bhagwan's nama, that same leela can be understood at adhyatmic level also. What is the... So there are few incidents that Goswamiji brings. One is Ahilya Uddhara. What is the symbolism behind Ahilya Uddhara? The story that we know is mostly Ahilya was cursed by that by Gautam Rishi. She became a stone. Bhagwan came, his dust of the feet touched, and then she came back. That is one understanding. But Goswamiji here gives a little more deeper insight. Who is Ahilya? Then later he tells the story of Tadaka, Subahu, and Maricha. Who are they? Bhagwan killed them, Adidevika story. That is good. But what is the adhyatmic implication of that? Both are important. Huh? That story also we should not say, oh, those are just stories. We should understand both aspects. And then third incident he brings is of Swayamvara. That, okay, Bhagwan went and broke that Shivadhanush. But what was that Shivadhanush? So that we will see now. Okay, 23rd Doha onwards.
Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Rama 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 Ram Bhagat Hit Nar Tanu Dhari राम भगत हित नर तनु धारी सही संकट किए साधु सुखारी नाम उस प्रेम जपत अनयासा भगत हो ही मुद मंगल बासा राम एकता पसतिय तारी नाम कोटि खल कुमति सुधारी ऋषि हित आम सुकेतु सुताकी सहित सेन सुत कीन बिबाकी सहित दोष दुख दास दुरासा दलई नाम जिमिर बिनिसिनासा भंजेउ राम आपु भव चापु भव भय भंजन नाम प्रतापु दंडक बनु प्रभु कीन्ह सुहावन जनमन अमित नाम किय पावन निसिचर निकर दले रघुनंदन नामु सकल कलि कलुष निकंदन सबरी गीध सुसेवकनी सुगति दीन्ह रघुनाथ नाम उधारे अमित खल वेद विदित गुण गाथ सियावर रामचंद्र की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय उमापति महादेव की जय बोलो भाई सब संतन की जय सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय
If it's somebody playing tabla, they can adjust the talam according to if I make a mistake. But this app doesn't know. It will keep going. All right. So now Goswamiji is saying, Ram Bhagat Hita Naratanu Dhari. Sahi Sankata Kiye Sadhu Sukhari. This is the same line of thinking that he said before. That Nirguna Brahma itself takes Saguna form because of devotees who are wanting to see Bhagwan in that form. Ram Bhagat Hita Naratanu Dhari. Those who want to refer can refer back to 13 Doha. Not now, later you can see. Third Chaupai or something, there this point had come. That same Nirguna Brahma with devotee's heart as upadi becomes saguna. Sahi sankatakiye sadhu sukhari. Bhagwan came here and he gave joy to many sadhu purushas by himself going through a lot of difficulties. That was during avatara time. But now Goswamiji has to prove that nama is greater than saguna rupa of Bhagwan. So he is saying, नामु सप्रेम जपत अनयासा भगत हूँ ही मुद मंगलवासा दैट इवन नाउ डिवोटीज हु आर टेकिंग भगवान्स नेम दे are able to enjoy the same kind of sukham that those sadhu purushas enjoyed while Bhagwan was walking on this earth as one particular form, avatar. And only few sadhus could benefit at that time, but now so many of other sadhakas are able to benefit. So he says, now you tell me what is greater, Bhagwan's form or Bhagwan's name? Now next line is that portion of Ahilya Uddhara. Ram ekatapasati yatari nam koti khala kumati sudhari. So he says, Bhagwan Rama came and did Uddhara of Ahilya. Means avatara prayojana is to do Uddhara, not only samhara. Samhara means what? Getting rid of Rakshasas. That Bhagwan can do anyway. It is said, you know, Bhagwan who can create so many Brahmandas, for him to get rid of Ravana, he doesn't have to come specially. But Ahilya Uddhara, he has to come because that is what the devotee has asked for. Ram Bhagat Hit, Ram Ekata Pasatiya Tari. Bhagwan Rama did Uddhara of Ahilyaji. Then he gives the symbolism of it. Nama koti khala kumati sudhari. Taking Bhagwan's name, this kumati which is there, all our sadhakas who are doing this sadhana, Goswamiji says, our mind is like that. You know, it is kumati. That gets changed into sumati with nama japa. So what is the symbolism here? So Ahilyaji story, all of you know, right? Ahilyaji was the wife of Gautam Rishi. And Indra deceives her. He takes the form of Gautam Rishi and Ahilyaji is not able to recognize Indra when he comes as Gautam Rishi. And when Gautam Rishi comes back, he gets very angry at Ahilyaji and gives her Shrapa. Okay, this is the Adi Daivika story now. Now you see the Adhyatmika part of it. He says, Ahilyaji represents our Kumati. I mean, the sadhaka is told again and again, there is no happiness in objects. And sadhaka understands, with some objects, he is able to understand this. But when this sukham comes disguised at some other objects, which are his weak points, then he falls for it. And for that kind of an intellect, this sadhana is a great blessing. I mean, some shrapa should come by which we understand the limitation of that sense object. And once this limitation has been understood by doing this sadhana, by taking Bhagwan's name, this kumati becomes changed into sumati. Vishaya bhoga should go away. That mind is called as sumati. And now it is such that it doesn't get deluded by any name and form. Ahilyaji's story, that is the symbolism. That in one name and form, Gautam Rishi it could recognize. But when some other Vishaya took that name and form, then she was not able to recognize. So in this sadhaka, this conviction has taken so clearly that this sadhaka doesn't get shaken now. And to reach to that stage, it is said, Nama Japa will help us there. So this is the Adhyatmic aspect of that story. So whenever we hear, you know, several deeper insights or meanings of a story, sometimes they come from these chaupais. In Vinaya Patrika also, Goswamiji has opened up a lot of hidden meanings of Ramayana. Next one we will see quickly. Then he says, Rishi Hita Rama Suketu Sutaki. Suketu Suta is Tadaka. So for saving all the rishis, Bhagwan Ramchandraji destroyed Tadaka. Sahita Sena Suta Kinha Vibaki. Along with all the senas that they had, all the demons that were there, and Maricha and Subahu. They were the sons of Tadaka. One was Maricha, another one was Subahu. Bhagwan killed all of them, except Maricha. Huh? Subahu he killed and Tadaka also he killed. Now what is the symbolism? Next line. Sahita dosha dukha dasa durasa. Durasha is the name of Tadaka. Durasha means what? Some negative quality, having this expectation that I'll be able to get along even if I do this wrong thing. That is called as Durasha. For example, very simple example I will give. Telling a lie. That is, you know, not a good virtue. Asuri vritti it is. Having this notion that I will get away somehow or the other by telling a lie. That vritti of expecting to get along or cross over by using some, you know, negative quality, that is called as Durasha. Now, who is the son of Durasha? Dosha and Dukha. If this thought is there, that, you know, somehow or the other we will cross over, that will force us to do some kind of wrong thing. That is Dosha. So Dosha is Maricha. And result of that Dosha is going to be Dukha, who is Subahu. So Durasha is Tadaka. Her sons are Dosha and Dukha, Maricha and Subahu. He says, Bhagwan Ramchandraji took care of all of them in Adidaivika story. But in Adhyatmik story, he will take care of my heart. If our heart has some kind of this Durasha, then Nama Japa will help us take that Durasha away. Durasha and Dukha, Bhagwan killed right then and there. Means sorrow won't be there once Bhagwan has taken roots in our heart. But Dosha, Maricha, it is said, he put an arrow without any tip and then he shot at Maricha. Maricha went and fell far away, you know, several miles away. But then after that, he started doing Rama Nama Japa. Wherever he saw two things, there he would remember Ra and Ma. Even if two trees were there, he would think there is Rama and Lakshmanji. Both of them have come. So what is the indication there? That a sadhaka, Bhagwan gives chance. Because doshi is this sadhaka. So again, if the sadhaka has to improve, Bhagwan says, I will give you one more chance. So the same, you know, sadhaka has to become, he has to progress forward on his sadhana. So Bhagwan gives that chance. Sahita dosha dukha dasa durasa dalai naam ujimi rabi nisanasa. So Bhagwan's name is such, once that is taken, all durashas which are there in our heart, they will go away. Dukkha will go away. And this doshi sadhaka who is there, he will become, you know, a good sadhaka, a better sadhaka. Okay, so we'll pause here. Next leela we will see in the next class. What is this Dhanush Bana? You know, I'll tell you some secret of, I know there are a lot of Ramcharitmanas premis over here. Sudhish Rotas are there. Whichever dohas we are going to cover, if you get time, you can just glance through the literal meaning of it before the class. Dohas which we are going to cover next. So then when we chant, something or the other will strike more. It will stay with us longer. And every doha has a theme. That theme you can note down. That also when we do Parayanam, that whole Prakaranam will become more vivid. Okay, that is the whole purpose of going verse by verse, chaupai by chaupai. Okay, so we'll pause here. We'll do our Nama Sankirtanam. There are some announcements, so please stay back.
Thank you.
अगणित गुण गण भूषण रामा आश्रित वत्सल जय जय रामा अयोध्यावासी सीता रामा आपद बांधव जय जय रामा दशरथ नंदन श्री रामा दशमुख मर्दन जय जय रामा कौसल्या सुखवर धन रामा कामित फलदा जय जय रामा पाप विमोचन श्री रामा पठाभिरामा जय जय रामा जानकी वल्लभ सीता रामा जय रघुरामा जय सीतारामा वानर सेवित श्री रामा वारिधि वंदन जय जय रामा हनुमत पूजित सीता रामा श्री राम जय जय रामा रघुपति राघव राजा रामा पतित पावन सीता रामा जय जय रामा श्री राम जय जय रामा सियावर रामचंद्र की जय श्री सद्गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय हरिओम।